فلله الحمد رب السماوات ورب الأرض رب العالمين.
وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Inshallah ta'ala, we will continue our class, Aqidatul Wasitiyya. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we will begin with some sifatillah ta'ala, some attributes of Allah subhanahu wa azza wa jal. Qala ta'ala, fallahu khayrun hafidhan wa huwa arhamur rahimin. Wa qawluhu subhanahu wa ta'ala, radiyallahu anhum wa radu anhu. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما. These ayats are covering so many attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قال تعالى فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. فالله خير حافظا. أي الله سبحانه وتعالى His حفظ His protection are better than any protection that comes from the human being. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى gives you protection, that protection really better than any other protection that comes from human being or other creation that Allah created. طيب. وهو أرحم الراحمين. طيب. And he's the merciful. طيب. And the Shaykh رحمه الله, he brought this ayah to show that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a name of Al-Hafidh. Al-Hafidh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who makes the hifz upon his creation. And hifz is two types. Hifzuhu ala ibadihi jami'a ma'amilu min khayrin wa shar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserves everything that his ibad, his servants, whatever they may do, whether they say something or they do something, all their affairs will be preserved and was put in a book. Any good or any bad, whatever they may do, that will be in a record and will be preserved. فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا. Another hifz is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu azza wa jal, will protect his slaves, special protects his awliya, the good doers. Always they may have good protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam. So this ayah, we will benefit from this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sifat al-rahmah, and that sifat is a sifat al-kamal, is a haqiqah, is truth, true sifat for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not majaz like the Ahlul Bid'ah said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mawsufun bisifat al-mada الرحمة وأنه سبحانه وتعالى خير حافظ. نعم. طيب. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. الله سبحانه وتعالى when he mentioned the good deeds of the believers And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them in the day of judgment. He will give them His Jannah, and they will be pleased for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, radiyallahu anhum. Allah pleased with them, and they pleased Allah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah has sifatul rida. Sifatul rida belongs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kama yaliq bi jalalihi. Sifatul rida subhanahu wa ta'ala kama yaliq bi jalalihi. But the Ahlul Bid'ah, they said, when Allah said radiyallahu anhum, they don't attribute to Allah sifatul rida, rather they make ta'wil about it. And what they said, iradatul ihsan, they will change to irada. Iradatul ihsan, iradatul thawab. All the time, all the sifat are sifatul rida, sifatul mahabba, sifatul ghadab, sifatul intiqam. All these sifat, they don't attribute to Allah and they don't affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, they will change it to the what? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to reward them or wants to punish them. That's what they said. But Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala these qualities, these sifat, in a way it's not like the way of the human being, the way of his creation. So the Shaykh all the time will bring all the sifat Allah ta'ala, that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah will affirm to Allah. And we will take the sifat from the Quran and from the Sunnah. The Quran affirms that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu azza wa jal, has these sifat. No one gives that sifat except Allah Himself and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. So رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه صفة الرضا لله سبحانه وتعالى وقوله سبحانه وتعالى ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما ومن يقتل مؤمنا whoever kills the believer. Anyone who kills a believer muta'ammidan, intentionally, someone carried out a weapon in order to kill a believer person, mu'min. Because killing a believer person is haram. Okay? It is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbidden that. In the Sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also, he said in a day of the ماذا حجّة الوداع, he said, فَإِنَّ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ حَرَامٌ. We should preserve for every believer his nafs and his wealth and his honor. It should be sacred. And no one can make dhulm upon it. So if someone carry out and kill a believer, mu'min, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us his recompense, his jaza. He said, فَجَزَاءُهُ جَهَنَّمُ. His recompense is going to be hellfire, jahannam. خَالِدًا فِيهَا, he will stay so long. On top of that, وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angered upon him. وَلَعَنَهُ, and he cursed him out. وَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا, and he prepared for him a great punishment. So this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mentions so many rules against the one who kills a believer. So Allah subhanahu, another ayah said, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ أَن يَقْتُلَ مُؤْمِنًا إِلَّا خَطَأً. No believer can kill another believer except خطأ, mistakenly. Someone was trying to do something or to shoot animal, but the person came in the middle and that person died. In that case, any mistake is acceptable because his intention was not to kill anybody. Or he was driving car in the street and a person came to the street and he killed. Whatever may be the case, the mistake could happen. And when he kills mistakenly, there is a diyah, blood money. We pay the diyah for his relatives. But when is he killed intentionally, this is a really great sin. Scholars, they said, the biggest sin after the shirk, after committing shirk, is killing a believer. Also, it's killing to an innocent person, even may not be Muslim. Sharia will forbid that. Okay? There's no just, you know, killing like that and you're free to go. There's no way. Unless the battlefield with the enemies of Islam, those who want to attack the Muslim state and to kill the believers, then to defend yourself and in the state of Islam, you have to be in a battlefield, and that's only the way. But other way, there is no way to kill somebody. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here, when it comes to the believer, his blood was sacred and you kill him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he will enter into Jahannam, khalidan fiha. So the word khalidan fiha, is he kafir? Because we know the kuffar, they will stay in hellfire forever. But this person, he's a Muslim, but he committed the killing. Would he stay forever? The scholars, they said khalidan al-khulud huna. The meaning of khalidan means he will stay longer, but he's not going to stay forever. He comes out. Say, what is the dalil? Because we have in the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, someone who has killed some people and he entered into Jannah. There is a famous hadith that in the previous nations, there is a man who was a mass killer. He used to kill everybody. He disagreed with him. And what happened? He killed 99 people. And he asked a monk, do I have tawbah? I really want to change. I just want to make tawbah about it. You know, is there any tawbah for me? You know, Allah will forgive me. And he said, the monk, you know, oh, you kill 99 people and you're asking about a tawbah? Man, get out of my face. Once he said that, the guy became more angry and he killed the rahib. And he completed to the mi'ah. Subhanallah. And still he did not lose his hope, this man. He still went to search a scholar who can really give him good answer for his dilemma, his problem. And people showed him, show him a great alim, scholar. And he asked him, he said, do I have tawbah? The alim says, yes, you do have tawbah. No one can really prevent you to make tawbah. So what do you want to do? You should go another city where people are good people. This city that you are living is not a good city. So he's gonna rather they not help you to make Tawbah. Okay? So he took the advice and he went to the city, the Sheikh told him. While he was in the middle of the street, he died. And Allah has sent, subhanahu wa ta'ala, two angels. Angels of hellfire and angels of what? Paradise. Yeah, they said, this man, he never did good, any good deeds, so he belongs to hellfire. Now they said, this person, Malaikatul Rahma said, this person has to go to what? To Jannah, because he came while he's fully repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah has sent an angel to, you know, judge between two angels, hellfire. Then in the end of the story, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, just measure to the two lands where he committed the killing and where he was going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be the good people. And then they found him, this guy, close to the good land, and he became one of that land, and he accepted and he entered into Jannah. In this hadith and a similar hadith, they indicate a person, if he kill someone again, he can what? Make the tawbah about it and be submitted to Jannah. But the scholars, they said also there is a three rules will be dependent on a person who kills someone. Three rights: the haqq Allah, the haqq al baqtul, wa haqq al waratha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a right. A person who disobey him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive him. Okay. The right for his relatives. Also, they can ask either diyah, what we call blood money, or money blood, whatever they call. And the third, the person who was killed, he will come in the day of judgment, and he said in front of Allah, oh Allah, ask this person why he killed me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he wants khair for that person, he will, you know, satisfy that person until he forgive him and enter into Jannah. So there is one statement in the ulama, they said, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, a person who killed a believer, he has no tawbah at all. But that's not the case. It has so many interpretation for the statement of ibn Abbas. طيب. في هذه الآية, there is a sifa for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sifatul ghadab. لله عز وجل. We attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifat al-ghadab, anger. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ sifatul fi'l. طيب. And Ahlul Bid'ah, usual, as you know, always, they don't attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifat al-fi'liyyah. They said, iradatul intiqam. He wants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to just revenge or retaliate or to banish him. That's what they interpreted all the time. The Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaghdab. That ghadab is not the way we have as a human being. When we have anger, it's not like that. We don't know the kayfiyyah. We attribute to Allah the sifa, and the kayfiyyah is majhula. We don't know. So no one can deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifa, sifatul ghadab. There is a hadith also from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will attribute himself al ghadab. Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. My mercy overcome my anger. The anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is a levels. That's hadith coming in the day of judgment. The Anbiya, they will say, Inna Rabbi qad ghadiba al-yawma ghadaban lam yaghdab qablahu wa lam yaghdab ba'dahu. So they take, there's a levels of the ghadab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The highest level of ghadab, it will be in the day of judgment. Okay. So all these sifat we have to affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way will not resemble the makhluqat, as we said in the beginning of the kitab. طيب. So either we will benefit this ayah that we always stay away from, you know, trying to harm a believer. All the time, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-Muslimu man salima al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadi. The Muslim is the person that other Muslim can be saved from his tongue and his hand. You don't say bad about the believer. Rather, you don't harm him physically. You become a believer and Muslim. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى ذلك بأنهم اتبعوا ما أسخط الله وكرهوا رضوانه وقوله تعالى فلما آسفونا انتقمنا منهم. These two ayahs also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes about the kuffar. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disliked them and anger upon them? Because they hated his shara, his deen, the faith, the iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ. They were punished and they were prepared for punishment because اتبعوا, they followed ما أسخط الله, that which make anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they hate his ridwan, his blessing, his pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anyone who denies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shara' and follow other than Allah's shara', he dislikes the ridwan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is very difficult. So all the time we should love the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the shara', especially in the implementation of the sharia, ruling of the sharia. We should accept it and we should obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by implementation of the sharia. طيب. So the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributes himself sifat wada, ithbat sifat al-sukht wal-rida in this ayah. Al-sukht wal-ghadab. Also the next ayah, فَلَمَّا أَسَفُونَ انْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ. Al-asaf. All these ayahs are just indicating one single sifa, which is sifatul ghadab, wa sifatul sukht, wal asaf. All these sifat belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way Allah suitable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not like the sifatul naqs. Sifatul naqs is not sifatul ghadab, wa sifatul sukht, wa sifatul asaf. They are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifatu kamal. فَلَمَّا آسَفُونَا انْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ. When they anger us, we ish, انْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ, we revenged from them. آسَفُونَا, the asaf has two meanings, as ulama said, rahimahullah, asaf bi-ma'na he's sad, sadness. In that meaning, it's haram to attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because being sadness is sifat naqs. Okay? It's not sifat kamal. Imperfect, perfect sifat. Naam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said another ayah. Ya asafa ala yusuf wa biyadad aynah. Nabila Yaqub. Wa asafa ala yusuf. Oh my, grieving, or my, huzn, my sadness, like that. That's not sifat kamal. It's haram to attribute Allah. But another meaning, which is the wrath and anger of Allah, that has a dalil to attribute Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam. So sifat al-ghadab, wa-sukht, wa-al-asaf, لله سبحانه وتعالى in the way that's suitable to Allah سبحانه عز وجل. We don't say like the Asha'ira and deviant groups saying all the time, إرادة الانتقام. Yeah, he wants to banish, he wants to this and that. صفة الرضا والرضوان, they attribute إرادة what? الثواب. وقوله ولكن كره الله بعاثهم فثبطهم وقيل اقعدوا مع القاعدين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the mushrikeen, I mean about the hypocrites in the Medina. The hypocrisy is المنافقون, all the time they pretend that they are believers, and whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands his messenger and the believers to go and to wage war against the enemies of Allah, these munafiqun, they hide and they get busy not to, and you know, in intention not to go with the Prophet ﷺ into the battlefield. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when he saw their hearts filled with the nifaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ولكن كره الله بعاثهم فثبطهم وقيل اقعدوا مع القاعدين. Why they did not come with the Prophet ﷺ and go with him and participate for defense of the deen of Allah? Because their heart was filled nifaq. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kariha Allah. Allah disliked in bi'athahum. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give motivation to go. Rather, fathabatahum. He make them lazy and sluggish and not to go with the messenger of Allah because of what they have in their hearts. In this ayah, Shaykh Al-Thaymin rahimahullah ta'ala said, a person, if he see that he always lazy to go with the khair, he has to really correct his heart. Whenever you see people are doing khair, you're behind. Whenever people cause to do khair, you don't want to participate for no reason. You have ability, you have everything, but for some reason you don't want to do it. So that's the what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inflicted to the hypocrites, al-munafiqun. Allah made them to stay and not allow them to go with the khair, with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his messenger, as his companion. So we have to scare all the time by not being with the khair and with the doing, people doing khair, inshallah ta'ala. Naam. Tayyib. So the sifa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, kariha Allahum bi'athahum. Tayyib. دليل على إثبات صفة البغض لله سبحانه وتعالى كما يليق بجلاله وعظمته. الكره والسخط والغضب, all of them just are صفات الله جل وعلا. نعم. كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. In this ayah also Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned, he said سورة وذا سورة الصف, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون. Oh, you believe, why you say something that you don't act upon it. كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his anger became greater and big. The anger became bigger in the sight of Allah to say something that which you don't act upon it. Okay. So that it's haram a person to say something is gonna do it and then he don't do it. That's the characters of munafiqun. They give a person people to the promise and they don't fulfill the promise. The Muslim believer has to fulfill his promises as long as he can. If something happened out of his power, That's not the case. But we must try to fulfill and to complete our promises and whatever we wanna, you know, wanna do for others. So the dalil for the ayah is al-maqt. ماذا؟ Which is ghadab. He brought 4 or 5 ayat to show sifatul ghadab لله سبحانه وتعالى صفة البغض كما يليق لجلاله سبحانه عز وجل. طيب وقوله تعالى هل ينظرون إلا أن يأتيهم الله في ظلل من الغمام والملائكة هل ينظرون إلا أن يأتيهم الله في ظلل من الغمام والملائكة. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ Do they wait? إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمُ اللَّهِ Except that Allah will come to them. فِي ظُلَلٍ مِّنَ الْغَمَامِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ In the shades of غَمَام. غَمَام is soft clouds. والملائكة مع الملائكة. Allah will come to them while the angels surrounding the whole creation of Allah with these clouds of soft clouds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to them. And that is the day of judgment. So, هل ينظرون انتظار means they wait. It's not seen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah indicated sifat al-ityan. Sifat what? Al-ityan. Allah will come to his creation. And that ityan, we don't know the kayfiyyah. Ityan and coming, it's not like the way we came as a human being. Or as creation of Allah. When we say someone is coming, comes from somewhere by walking or by car or by something. But in outside of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not like that. Why people of Al-Bid'ah don't affirm to Allah sifatul maji' wal ityan? Because they have what we call tashbih awalan. The ityan of Allah and ityan of makhluq, they say it's the same. Once they say it's the same, that's tashbih. So they said, since that is a tashbih, we deny it. But Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said, ityan Allah of Allah, the maji and ityan of Allah and his khalq are different. What we know is for makhluq, but for the khaliq, we never know it. So we never deny whatever Allah attributes to himself as a maji wal ityan sifa lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. وفيه مجيء الملائكة يوم القيامة لأنهم يحيطون بالإنس والجن ثم ينزل الله سبحانه وتعالى فصل القضاء بينهم. نعم. وفي another آية وقضى ماذا قال؟ وقضي الأمر وإلى الله ترجع الأمور. طيب وقضي الأمر وإلى الله ترجع الأمور. And the end of the ayat, all the ayats, yeah, the ayat هل ينظرون إلا أن الملائكة في ظلل من الغمام والملائكة وقضي الأمر وإلى ترجع الأمور. That's the whole ayat together. What we benefit is صفة الإتيان, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى will come to his creation. As we mentioned, these Ahl Bid'ah, they said, if we affirm to Allah, ityan means he is a jism. And al-ajsam mutamathila. And then that's going to be tashbih. So they have a philosophy all the time to deny the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is wrong and against the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ رَبُّكَ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ. Another ayah is similar to the one we mentioned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. Do they wait except that the angels will come to them to take their lives? When the angels came into the kuffar, لِقَبْضِ أَرْوَاحِهِمْ, to take their lives. أَوْ يَأْتِيَ رَبُّكَ, or are they waiting except that Allah will come to them to judge them in the day of judgment? أَوْ يَأْتِيَ بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ, or do they wait except to come some signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is طُلُوعُ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا, that the sun will rise from the west and go down to the east. Right now the sun rises in the morning from where? From the east, and says to the west. It will be like different, opposite side. It will raise up from the west and sets into the east. When that sign came, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَ يَأْتِي بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ لَا يَنْفَعُ نَفْسٌ إِيمَانُهَا لَمْ تَكُنْ آمَنَتْ مِنْ قَبْلُ. The tawbah, the door of the tawbah will be closed. And once the door closed, everyone will become believer. Everyone who leaves that time, they will accept the what? The Tawheed and Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never accept that. In the Sahihain, in the Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تقوم الساعة حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. The hour will never established until the sun raises up from the west. فإذا طلعت ورآها الناس آمنوا أجمعون. When the sun raises from the west and people saw it, everyone will become believer. فَذَٰلِكَ حِينَ لَا يَنْفَعُ نَفْسًا إِيمَانُهَا لَمْ تَكُنْ آمَنَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And that's the time, no faith will benefit any soul, that which will never become before that sign believer. So this ayah also indicates the sifat what? Al-Ityan. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to His creation to judge them. Naam. All the creation of Allah, they will come down to one place. The angels will come down and they surround all the creation of Allah. Then Allah subhanahu will come in a way suitable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't know how Allah will come. Okay?
كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا.
نعم. Another ayah, الله سبحانه وتعالى he said وجاء ربك. كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا. When the earth will destroyed, when the hour comes, this earth will be destroyed, this, and in heaven is everything. And then after that is going to be the resurrection. And Allah will come to, for reckoning and for hisab, for judgment, subhanahu wa azza wa jal. So maji wa ja'a rabbuk, sifatul maji lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. But people of Ahlul Bid'ah, they said, huna hudifat minhu al-mudaf. Or they call something, وَجَاءَ أَمْرُ رَبِّكَ. They were both Amr. And this is really putting some statements in the book of Allah without evidence. So Maji of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ithbatul Maji, Sifatul Fi'l, Sifatul Fi'liyah, Sifatul Maji, wa Sifatul Nuzul, wa Sifatul Ityan, all of it is attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bima yaliqu bi jalalihi wa adamatihi. Sifatul Fi'liyah, يجب إثبات جميع الصفات الواردة في كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. All the صفات فعلية we should attribute to Allah سبحانه وتعالى as long they came through the Quran and Sunnah. من غير التكييف ولا تمثيل. Without giving the كيفية or resembling to the creation of Allah. نعم. وَيَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ السَّمَاءُ بِالْغَمَامِ وَنُزِّلَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ تَنْزِيلًا النزول صفة النزول الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling us that the day of judgment the angels will come down with these al-ghamam and we mentioned the ghamam is soft clouds which Allah will create After destruction of the heavens and earth, the angels, all of them, they come down with these clouds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, yanzil subhanahu azza wa jal. Naam. So the sifat al-ityan wal-maji wal-nuzul, sifat fi'liyah, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, min ghayri tashbihin. ولا تكييف ولا تعطيل affirm to Allah سبحانه وتعالى طيب وقوله سبحانه عز وجل كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام الشيخ start another chapter which is صفة الوجه لله سبحانه وتعالى affirmation the face of Allah سبحانه وتعالى طيب قال جل وعلا كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام كل من عليها فان everything that exists on this earth will vanish will die everything will vanish everything exists will vanish except كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام only your the face of your Lord ذو الجلال والإكرام that face which has الجلال and honor it will يبقى it will stay forever Allah سبحانه وتعالى but everything else That Allah want to destroy it, it will be destroyed, and they die. Some creation of Allah, they may remain. For example, Al-Jannah wa-Nar, the hellfire in paradise, they already was prepared, and they are exist now, as in the revelation of Quran and the Sunnah indicated. So, in this ayah, is not included the existence of hellfire and paradise because Allah created them to stay forever. Also the arsh. So the scholars, they mentioned couple, you know, creation of Allah. Allah will give them to stay forever. And does not mean that they are not created. They were created and they are, you know, they will stay because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed them to stay. طيب so this ayah فيها الدليل على أن الله أن لله سبحانه وتعالى وجها that Allah has a face and another ayah also كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه
كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَ. Everything will vanish and die except the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إثبات صفة الوجه لله سبحانه وتعالى كما يليق بجلاله. We don't know how the face of Allah should look like, but we have to affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not majaz, it's not something, it's not a fiction, it's a حقيقة, it's a truth. لا يشبه وجه آخر. No other faces look like. لأن الله ليس كمثله شيء. We don't know the كيفية, how does look like Allah's face. We don't know that. But Allah said Allah has a face, and we accept that. And there is a hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنَامُ. Allah does not sleep. وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not suitable to sleep for him. حِجَابُهُ نُورٌ. His barrier between him and his creation are light. لو كشفه, if Allah removes this barrier between him and his creation, لأحرقت صبحات وجهه منتهى إليه بصره من خلقه. The subhat, the light and shining that comes, the rays comes to the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will burn out wherever his sight reaches. The sight of Allah reached everywhere. So the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shining has a sifa, shining, and Allah subhanahu azza wa jal, if he removed the hijab, it will burn his face, the shyness of his face, everything. So how come someone said Allah does not have face, while the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam giving details about the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is really against the Quran and Sunnah. Naam. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So this about إثبات صفة الوجه لله سبحانه وتعالى هو المنهج الصحيح لله عز وجل. Another hadith, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا دخل أحدكم المسجد وقال أعوذ بالله العظيم وبوجهه الكريم وبسلطانه القديم من الشيطان الرجيم. طيب, الله سبحانه وتعالى now he said أعوذ بالله العظيم وبوجهه الكريم. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned his being بالله العظيم, then specifically he mentioned again his face وبوجهه الكريم. And the wajh has sifa. He attributed the honor, the wajh al-kareem. So all these ahadith and ayats are indicating that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a face. And we don't know how it looks like, that face. That's the difference between Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah and people of Ahl Bid'ah, who all the time denies and make ta'wil and tahrif these ayat and hadith. Tayyib. Sifat al-wajh, he brought Shaykh these two ayats. Now he moves again to another sifat, which is صفه اليد. قال الشيخ رحمه الله تعالى ما منعك ان تسجد لما خلقت بيدي. الله سبحانه وتعالى is talking to Iblis, الشيطان. This ayah has a sabab, a cause. Iblis, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى created Adam, our father Adam, Allah سبحانه عز وجل and commanded all the angels and Iblis to make sujood, prostration for Adam, to greet him. All the angels, they made a sujood except the Iblis. He rejected and objected the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla asked him, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقَ. What prevent you to prostrate what I have created, both my hands, biyadayya. So the Iblis said, Ana khayru minhu, I am better than him. Why? خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن طِينٍ. You created me out of fire and you created me out of mud and teen. So the fire is a light and teen is a what? Something else. So now he's just making an analogy. The teen and the fire, which one is better? You're not telling your Lord who created you that. This is a really salt and a soul adab. Okay? Allah created angels from the light, nur. And yet they made prostration for Adam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what the real cause for Iblis. Not to mention sujood is al-kibr, said. Illa Iblis aba wastakbar. Wa kana min al-kafirin. So the kibr and belittle others is really very dangerous. All the time we should accept the haqq. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to make sujood for everything He wants, you don't have just but to accept. Because He's the what? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands you. You don't have what? You don't have judge. He didn't give you judge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the deal here is, ما منعك أن تسجد لما خلقت. نعم.
Socks.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave this specification for Adam that He created both His hand, which is a special thing. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam kun fayakun, he would be like other creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like heavens and earth and everything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given special way and honored him, Adam, by creating by both his hands. So affirming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala both hands is a sifat liyad lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then there's hadith came from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, لَمْ يَخْلُقِ اللَّهُ بِيَدِهِ إِلَّا ثَلَاثًا. Allah did not create it with His hand except three things. The rest of things Allah created by كُمْ فَيَكُونَ. But three things Allah created by His hand. طيب. Allah خلق آدم بيده وخلق الجنة بيده وَ I think another وَكَتَبَ التَّوْرَاتِ بِيَدِهِ, something like that. So many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that He ماذا خلقه بيده سبحانه وتعالى. طيب, قال ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى, ابن القيم said, ورد لفظ اليد, the word of hand, it came into the Quran and the Sunnah and the statement of the Sahaba and statement of the Tabi'een في أكثر من مئة موضع, more than 100 places in the Quran and the Sunnah and the statement of Sahaba and Tabi'een, all of them indicated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sifatul yad, more than 100, and they will never change. They will never said this is tashbih for the makhluq, or they never negated Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Allah, from a hand or something like that. طيب, وَوَرَدَتْ مُتَنَوِّعًا مُتَصَرِّفًا فيه مغرونة بما يدل على أنها يد حقيقية من الإمساك والطي والقبض والبسط والنضح باليد والخلق باليد والمباشرة بهما وكتب التوراة بيده وغرس الجنة عدن بيده. He said that the hand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributed himself is not ni'mah like the Ahlul Bid'ah all the time saying ni'mah or qudra. Why they say ni'mah and qudra? Because they said a hand, we have a human being hand, so we cannot attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, the wording that comes in the Quran Sunnah, they understand from it one thing, which is tashbih. Any sifa that comes into the Quran or into the Sunnah, they don't understand nothing but the tashbih, resembling. After that, they deny. But he said, this is a real and truth hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the dalil? He said, we have seen so many adilla kamis that the attribute Allah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that his hand extended or wrapped up to the samawat wal ard was samawat matwiyatun bi yamini. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wrap up all the heavens and earth to his right hand. Wal qabd, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how they call qabd in hand by catching. Naam. Wal bast wal nadh. So many sifat for the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, which indicates that the true hand which related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and suitable to Allah is not the way of the makhluqat. Okay? Naam. So, صفة اليد لله سبحانه وتعالى ثابتة. Another ayah, وقالت اليهود يد الله مغلولة غلت أيديهم ولعنوا بما قالوا بل يداه مبسوطتان ينفق كيف يشاء. See, يهود, they attribute to Allah سبحانه وتعالى صفات النقص. They said the hand of Allah مغلولة. مغلولة means it's another meaning of Allah is it's not given anything. Stinginess. والعياذ بالله. مخلوق. مغلوق means he closes hand. He don't give. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said غلت أيديهم. This is a curse out. Allah curses them out. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will close their hands and afflict them. Mada, stinginess. And that's exactly what happened to them. The Jews are very stingy people. They want everything. They don't want to pay anything. But the Prophet alayhi salam, another hadith. إِيَّاكُمْ وَالشُّحَّ. Or beware from stinginess. فَإِنَّمَا أَهْلَكَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ الشُّحَّ. The people before you was destroyed because of stinginess. حَتَّى سَفَكُوا دِمَاءً. Until they shed their blood. Everyone wants to have everything and they don't want to pay. They don't want to give. Naam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that to them. وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا. And they were cursed because what they have said about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that Allah said, بَلْ يَدَاهُ. Rather, his both hands, مَبْسُودَتَان, are extended and given day and night. See, whatever Allah created, is giving. Everyone receives the blessing of Allah, the provision of Allah, day and night, every minute, every second. So Allah cursed them out because they attribute to Allah sifat al-naqs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attribute to himself that his both hands are extended. This is another dalil for Sifatul Yad Lillah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Naam. مبسوطتان بالفضل والعطاء فهذه الآية كسابقتها فيها إثبات صفة اليد صفة اليدين لله سبحانه وتعالى كما يليق بجلاله وعظمته. Allah has two hands which is suitable to him. We don't know how they look like. They're not like مخلوقات. They're not like ours. As Allah attributes himself, leave it like that. Anyone who says Allah has like our hands, he's going to be kafir. Allah said, "Laysa kamithlihi shay." Anyone who denies Allah doesn't have hand also is going to be kafir because he denied the ayah. So we said, Allah has hands which suitable to him, and we don't know how they look like. He knows. It's not like ours. It's not like makhluqat. It's something only Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yunfiqu kayfa yashaa. Hada madhhab ahl sunnah wal jama'ah. Sheikh said, this is the way of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Naam. As we said, Inna Allah lam yubashir biyadihi aw lam yakhluq biyadihi illa thalatha. Khalaqa Adam biyadihi. Allah created Adam in his hand. Wa gharasa jannata adnin. He planted all the trees in Jannah by his hand. وَكَتَبَ التَّوْرَاهِ by his hand, سُبْحَانُهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. So inshallah ta'ala, we will affirm all these sifat. Today we took so many sifat. ماذا? We began with sifat, ماذا? Sifat al-ghadab, وصفت السخط, وصفت الانتقام, وصفة ماذا الكره والمقت والإتيان والمجيء ماذا والنزول وصفة الوجه وصفة اليدين. All this Sheikh brought by Adillah of Quran. And the way of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is to affirm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way is suitable to him. He knows him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala alayhi wa sallam ala Muhammad.